YouTube. Welcome to Hashtag Religion Week TV. I'm your host, Drew L. Murray, and here we sip a lot of tea with no shade, talking everything up the Yahweh. Enjoy the video. Tea, no shade. Hey, everybody. How's it going? Hey y'all, what's going on today? I hope everyone is doing well today and striving to complete their goals and their dreams. It's a pleasure to be with you today and thanks for having me. Well, Miss Oprah Winfrey wants you all to know that it's all about her life. That is power and control. Guys, she says that she doesn't give a damn that she lied her way to the top, and she will do anything and everything that she possibly can to stay in power and in control. And guys, she also says, allegedly, that she will continue to lead people away from the truth by saying you don't need Christ to have a relationship with Yahweh God. And she also goes on to say that she will continue to deceive people as if she has love for all mankind except Christ. She goes on to say, guys, allegedly, that she will continue to use her power in Hollywood to keep those in Hollywood who allow themselves to be controlled by her, and she will continue also to use her control to keep those out of Hollywood who has enough sense not to be controlled by her and Satan. Especially if they don't desire to denounce Christ publicly, like Jay-Z, wear dresses like Tyler Perry, preach lies like T.D. Jakes, and simply just sell their souls like Beyonce, Nicki, Kanye, Jennifer Hudson, and many, 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 the Kardashians, many, 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 many more. Oprah loves to control people, y'all, and she's a liar. Let's go right into the story and find out how. So tell me, how can this young, beautiful, sweet-looking young girl grow up to be so well-loved on one hand and yet extremely hated on the other hand? See, the Bible says God gives you the desires of your heart. And like Oprah and so many other people, greed, success, power, control, and deception has become the desires of their hearts. Just like their boss, the devil. See, little girls who are raised between two houses, like Oprah and so many other young ladies in the world, can be misconstrued as unstable, and the Bible says that a double-minded person, man, is unstable in all his or her ways. Now, Miss Oprah states this allegedly and openly because she is wrong about Christ and her decision about not needing Christ to have a relationship with Yahweh God, and she's unstable with her long time house nigga slave, Mr. Stedman, and her decision not to marry him all of this time. Because if she gets married, it will take away her control. Because the Bible says, wives, submit yourselves unto your husbands. And Oprah would never do that. And she wouldn't even give herself up to having children at this point in time in her long, lustrous career. Because why? kids can make you powerless sometimes as parents. We know that, right? We always crying out for help, asking God for help, send us some help. But Oprah isn't that kind of person. She isn't built for that because why? She's God. She basically thinks that she has it all in control, has everybody under control, and is so powerful. And let's continue on. You see, little girls like this right here, who like Oprah, and who grow up with her mindset and with her spirit in her, that kind of spirit in her, these girls don't look to get married. They don't look to have a man of their own. But what they do, y'all, everyone, is that they grow up to be having powerful friends like Harvey Weinstein, who goes around taking advantage of women, and hopefully not little girls like Oprah is in this picture right here. You understand what I'm saying? I guess he waits till they get to Hollywood and then use and abuse them. But Oprah's really good friends with him, and allegedly there's talk out there about her knowing that he took advantage of some women out here in the industry. So with that being said, y'all, make sure that when you're raising your children, especially your little girls, that you raise them in a way that they're powerful, successful, you know, go get it all, but not with manipulation and deception. Okay? So moving right along. Syndrome. As you're viewing the video, Oprah's eyes will be going to your right as you're facing the video, her left. And we all know that the great investigators of our time say, liars, look up and look left. Well, you be the judge of it. Let me know what you think.
Born, as I said, in rural Mississippi, 1954, and I was born at home. And there were not a lot of educated people around, and my name had been chosen from the Bible. My Aunt Ida had chosen the name, but nobody could really know how to spell it. So it went down as Orpah on my birth certificate, but people didn't know how to pronounce it. So they put the P before the R in every place else other than the birth certificate. So on the birth certificate, it is Orpah, but then it got translated to Oprah. So here we are. But that's great, because Oprah spells Harpo backwards. I don't know what. Oprah spells Harpo backwards. I don't know what Orpah spells. Oprah spells Harpo backwards. I don't know what Orpah spells. Oprah spells Harpo backwards. I don't know what Orpah spells. Oprah spells Harpo backwards. I don't know what Orpah spells.
Now, I do understand that there's some footage out there about Oprah's name being Orpah, like one of Naomi's daughters from the Bible, and daughter-in-law, excuse me. And I'm about this. I'm starting to believe that Oprah may hate everything about the Bible and everything about God inwardly, and it probably has something to do with her upbringing in part. Because she does say that she was raped and molested by a cousin or and maybe a family friend. But we're going to go into that next video. And then, again, just keep looking up and look left and tell me, you know, what you think about her being guilty of lying. And if she actually lied to get to where she is today. Let's move forward.
And I was raped when I was 9 by a cousin, and never told anybody until I was in my late 20s. Not only was I raped by a cousin, I was raped by a cousin, and then later sexually molested by a friend of the family, and then by an uncle. It was just an ongoing, continuous thing, so much so that I started to think, you know, this is the way life is. And not until, I'd say, a year ago did I release the shame for myself. Because I was in the middle of an interview with a woman named Trudy Chase, who has multiple personalities and was severely abused as a child. And I think it was on that day that I mean, for the first time I recognized that I was not to blame, because I became a sexually promiscuous teenager, and as a result of that, got myself into a lot of trouble and believed that I was responsible for it. It wasn't until I was 36 years old, 36, that I connected the fact, oh, that's why I was that way. I always blamed myself. Even though intellectually I would say to other kids, I would speak to people and say, oh, the child is never to blame. You're never responsible for molestation in your life. I still believed I was responsible somehow, that I was a bad girl. And just released it in the middle. And so it happened on the air, as so many things happened for me, happened on the air in the middle of somebody else's experience. And so I thought I was going to have a breakdown on television. And I said, you know, stop, you've got to stop rolling cameras. And they didn't. And so I sort of got myself through it. But it was really quite traumatic for me.
Now, because of Oprah's past, it led to some teenage prostitution and just being wayward with men. And she's probably that way to this day. You know, when people are actresses and actors, they put up a good front. And some actors and actresses are very well, not only on the big screen, but in their personal life as well. Let's move forward.
Well, I was living with my mother and living under circumstances that a lot of young children have to deal with today, even. We weren't living in the projects. And if you'd asked me at the time if we were poor, I probably would have said no, because when you are living it and you don't know anything else, you think that's the way life.
Now, y'all tell me, can this beautiful woman, as innocent as she look here, possibly have had abortions like some of you and I, maybe have a child out there that she's not claiming, and possibly just don't want to be a mother because of the responsibility, and she will lose power and control, as we all know who have children, that they can render us powerless sometimes, all in love though. And sometimes not, but Oprah doesn't want to surrender any of her power or her control to any other human being, because she is now the new female god, the only female god that, says when she was around 4, allegedly, she could remember, you know, wanting to be different. You be the judge.
Absolutely. Physically feeling it at around 4 years old. I remember standing on the back porch. It was a screened-in porch, and my grandmother was boiling clothes because, you know, at that time, we didn't have washing machines, and so people would, you know, physically boil clothes in a great big iron pot. She was boiling clothes and poking them up. And I was watching her from the back porch, and I was 4 years old, and I remember thinking, my life won't be like this. My life won't be like this, it would be better. And it wasn't from a place of arrogance, it was just a place of knowing that things could be different for me somehow. I don't know. Thank you.
guys, so let me know what you think. Is Oprah trying to be God? Well, that is the God, the world of the God of the world, because she knew any angel disguised as the light cannot enter into heaven. And is she, does she suffer with power control issues? And does she manipulate a lot of what's going on in Hollywood? Subscribe, like, and share. Leave your comments and thoughts below. And I do appreciate you all. Love you. Bye.